Good morning, friends. Today is World Health Day. It is being celebrated as a Global Awareness Health Day every year on 7th of April. And this year, the theme is revolving around the nursing and midwifery. As everybody is aware that we are going through a epidemic of coronavirus, and what can be the better day to appreciate and applaud the efforts put in by our front-running staff, which includes not only the doctors and senior clinicians, but also the nursing and the technical staff and midwifery staff, who are working day and night to take care of the patients coming into the hospital with suspected or a confirmed diagnosis of coronavirus infection. At the same time, I would like to highlight the strict measures and swift measures which have been taken by the government and healthcare agencies in controlling this deadly disease, and medical education or the health education which has been issued from time to time by the regulatory authorities are being followed very diligently, not only by the healthcare professional but also by the public at large. So on this day, I would like to convey my best wishes to all my healthcare staff who is not shying away from the responsibilities of taking care of the patients suspected with this infection. But at the same time, I would advise them to take care of their health as well, because if they keep fit, then only they can take care of their patients. They should be maintaining the social distancing, hand washing should become a norm, quarantine should be followed properly, and also the protective equipment and gear should be worn by healthcare professionals at all times. And also they should adhere to all the regulatory advisories given and issued by healthcare agencies from time to time, so that as a country, as a nation, we are able to fight out this virus very fast, very soon, without too much of loss to the manpower, human life, as well as the economic crisis. So my dear friends, on this World Health Day, we should pledge that we are going to support the government regulations and the advisories issued from time to time, and also take adequate measures to protect ourselves and our families from this dreaded infection. Thank you so much.